Well, we'll see the original penalty. There's the shot to the head of Hunter once and then twice with that elbow. And a cuff to the back of the head. Dale Hunter's not about to resist that. Wang, wang, wang. Remember?
Boston nothing, Los Angeles nothing. We'll return in a moment.
Gentlemen, you're seated in section 10.
They're going to go, and they'll let him go. They're two big bangers, Twist and Caulfield. Fourth time, and finally they get a shot at each other. Now just a lot of hugging. And you're looking at brute strength here, John Kelly. Jay Caulfield of the Penguins and Tony Twist of the Blues. And now the linesman will intercede, and Bill McCreary will come in, the referee, and tell them to cool down, and there'll be penalties again on Twist and Coffee.
Roberts and Carson going at it. Carson had his right hand loose. Roberts trying to free himself, and the two linesmen let these two big guys go, and Roberts is on the receiving end of Carson's right time after time. There's a lot of knuckles being fired. Carson seems to be handling himself well. Now Roberts is starting to get his left in. He sunk it in a couple of times on the right side of Carson's face. Is that a helmet or is that hair that he's got a hold of? Of course, it's a gross misconduct if they grab a hold of the hair. Believe it or not, you're allowed to punch the guy's teeth in, flatten his nose, cave in his cheekbone, but don't pull his hair. Ooh, Brian O'Neill looking at this. He won't have to look at the tape. He's seeing it firsthand.
Here he spent 3 weeks this summer at the Canyon Ranch, which is a fat farm in Arizona. He had three workouts a day, and he went from 214 pounds to 195 pounds. There we go. He found somebody that'll take him on. Bailey's a tough guy. And you can see that he was throwing it with the left, which makes it doubly tough. Unless you know he's going to lead with the left. Now Jeff Chicken seems to have things stabilized a little bit. I didn't see Paul Holmgren sneak Jeff Chicken onto the ice, Mike.
No, I didn't either. Well, I remember Samuelson was on.
I heard that one flip off Chicken's helmet from here.
Pumped.
Victor. He reached for it.
Oh, here we go. Verbeek and Jensen. And Jensen knocked down one of the Whaler players. The referee didn't see it, and then Jensen was skating away, and Verbeek came over and gave him a shot right in the nose. The referee did see that and had his hand up. Jensen's switching hands here. Verbeek loose with his right hand.
See the problem with there. Verbeek is Verbeek's got the shield on. And there's nowhere right. Jensen's can hit him.
Jensen has the reach, too. But Jansen's knocked down a Whaler player. The referee did not see that because I looked to see if the penalty would be called. And then Verbeek skated up to Jansen and popped him in the nose.
Let's see if Verbeek gets the instigator here.
At the action, it was quite a scuffle late in the period. A lot of bodies on the ice behind the New Jersey goal. But one body not there was Toronto goalie Ron LaForce. But he soon joined the action as he took on New Jersey goalie Sean Burke. And after some sort of order was finally achieved, things boiled over again as Lou Franceschetti was being escorted to the penalty box. The two goalies went at it again, and they were both ejected from the game. And the second period was called at the 17-14 mark, with the final 2 minutes and 46 seconds tacked on to the third period. When play and Vincent Domfus had assists, then Wendell Clark went after Vyacheslav Fetisov, but oddly was not hit with a fighting penalty.
The Maple Leaf Wrestling, it's Sean the Brawn Burke, and Macho Mark, my bark is worse than my punch, LaForest. The two goalies tried to scratch each other's eyes out during a second period brawl. Don't expect the WWF to call, boys. The girls of GLOW could show them a hold or two. That was embarrassing. This is pitiful. Wendell Clark shows why he's Harold Ballard's pet, bravely, single-handedly crushing the commies. Bewildered Fetisov.
Dumped back off, and Huffman is there. Drills one around, and we have a fight with Ewan and Chikrin, a couple of heavyweights near the Flyer goal.
Well, Jeff Chikrin seemed to take the same position as Jay Wells, no questions asked. Because Chikrin, I'm not sure Carey Fraser is going to give him an instigator, because they both seem to start pretty evenly. But Chikrin, you could tell that he was a guy that was wound up and ready to go. As soon as he dropped the gloves, he went fast and hard at Ewan, and that's something that Jeff Chikrin...
Watching him, and the shot went off twist. Cavallini had his helmet knocked right off by Berube, and there'll be a penalty on this. And now Twist has gone over, and he and Berube are going, primarily Berube at the stars.
Watch Twist. He'll cock his arm way back and try and throw a haymaker. There it is, right there. See how he's got that right hand cocked way back? That's the scouting report on Tony Twist. He'll take a shot to get a good grip, and then he'll start throwing haymakers. But boy, he's got a heavyweight against him there. Craig Berube did just fine on that set, too.
A couple of the good dancers who know how to dance.
LaForge grabs him. Kastelic will take McRae as a dance partner as we look at Gillis. And away from the action with Gillis and Jennings, we've got a battle brewing near the Hartford bench.
Down near the bench, Rick, it's Kastelic and Mark LaForge. They have a couple. You see McRae right there. I think he's hooked up with Kastelic.
Teams have had some legendary battles over the years, and it looks like they're set to resume such action here tonight. We've played just over 5 minutes in the first period, and Hartford leads it 1-0.
You know, the Whalers have played some of the best hockey they've played this season, put it that way. It's been when they've been aggressive. So they're somewhat aggressive. Oh, here we go.
LaForge and Kimball. And LaForge leads with a left, and Kimball comes back with a right hand. And LaForge and Kimball punching away furiously, and Kimball lands on top of this one, and LaForge is cut, and he is bleeding. And he's going to the dressing room, and the puck came right to LaForge, and he didn't even look at it. He was looking right at Kimball.
Well, there's no doubt about it. Mark LaForge received one in the left eye, and that's what opened him up. Kimball threw a good left there, and that's what got LaForge. LaForge was throwing the left, but he received the left, and that's what did the damage. Correct. But let's watch right from the start, right at the bottom of your screen. There goes the gloves. A little sparring right now. They're both going left-handed. I think the scouting reports were right-handed. I don't think he has cut him yet, but he's going to, it's with his right. In the left eye. Well, right there is where he opened it.
Most right wingers are.
That's right.
Left-handed. And we get the whistle, and now we've got Kastelic trying to go here with Danielle Dory. Kastelic's trying to work with the left, and now we'll go with the right, and Dory comes back, and wow.
Two pretty good ones.
The Sports Channel Pro Boxing Tour for the first period of the Whalers and the Quebec Nordiques. Good tussle there. Dory, the youngster who was drafted in 1988, he was the draft pick that Quebec received for Bergeron going to the Rangers. Then they get Bergeron back again.
And they say he did not clear the red line. Icing against Boston. And here goes Hartman now.
Hartman and Byers. Lyndon Byers. Hartman landed a couple. Byers landed a few early. Got another right in there. There's no blocking of punches here. Both of them are landing them. Says the wrestle to the ice is the actual victory. Not so. A hotly contested fight. Both guys can fight good.
Back comes Ray on the left wing. He drops it in. Wesley going back, and after him is Parker. Oh, belted him, and how about a penalty there? Oh, he hurt. And here comes Galley trying to get at Parker.
Galley and Parker tied up. Glenn Wesley. There's the win for Galley. And Wesley got hit awful hard. He lost his balance trying to turn direction going into the boards. Gary Galley protected him. Jumped Parker for him.
That's got to be 5 minutes.
Got to be.
That's Wesley with his back to the player and Parker. And Ray hit on the boards by Marquardt and held there. Let's see what happens on that one. There they go, Marquardt and Ray. Right in front of the Buffalo bench. Ray without the helmet.
And Bonita, one of them have the helmets. Ray much bigger than Marquardt.
And Devin Marquardt is not a good fighter. He's a snapper. And he was trying to stay close.
Actually getting into it. And they're not done. What the hey, you're out of there now. You might as well go fully exhausted. Actually getting into it. And they're not done. What the hey, you're out of there now. You might as well go fully exhausted. Goals are go-ahead goals. They're always big goals. Look at here.
Our lines with Race Campanello and Pat Capuzzo in their hands. On that Ranger goal, Turcotte from Leach and Patrick in 18:22 to make it 4-0 and put it out of reach. Right from the drop of the puck, this resulted. Chenault has had a running battle with several different Rangers tonight throughout the game.
Now he's got his hands full with some Ranger fans as they try to escort him down the runway toward the Islander dressing
Jersey fans down in that area giving it to Dakota. Now Nielsen and Arbor are ready to exchange some unpleasantries here.
I don't believe that. I figured Roger Nielsen was ready to get off the ice and get in the dressing room. He went after Al Arbor, giving him a real earful, and Arbor said, okay, you want to go, let's go. Arbor walked all the way up to the bench. I suppose Nielsen is upset with the fact that Arbor sent Vic Dakota out at the end of the game, as Al tries to get all of his players now into the dressing room. Nothing to be accomplished now, but Nielsen gave Al Arbor a piece of his mind as the teams were trying to exit.
Fights, but Pat Kakuzov telling Al Arbor that that wasn't necessary, and discussing some of the other things that went on, including the match penalty against Ballette. The final score is the Rangers 4, the Islanders 1. We'll have a recap.